lot. So we knew when they didn't get the evac report that we was definitely still in the game. And the team, you know, my hat goes off to Havre de Grace, they brought it. You know, and like I told my team all week, is that when you come into a game like this and, you know, everyone didn't give them a chance. I mean, when you're reading the newspapers and stuff and no one gave them a chance, and, you know, that's easy motivation for a team. And they came out and they played, but, you know, my team, they showed up in the second half and played. My hats go off to both my coordinators, you know, Travis Blacks and then Michael Carter, for the adjustments that they made at halftime, straightened some things out. And we really came forward and the team performed the second half.
Talk about doing some unconventional things offensively to get a big spark. I mean, that pass play was quite a big turnaround, I think, for you guys.
Well, our offensive coordinator, he called the play in the first half, but I believe it was a timing problem, you know, for the first half. And I can tell you this, he practiced that play probably every practice. Mm-hmm. He practiced that play, and you always, when you get to these games, you don't hold nothing back. So that play really helped us out in the second half, and it really was a spark for the team. Mm-hmm. And then that really, you know, set us up to keep on moving.
Coach, it seemed like you guys did a better job with a blitz pickup in the second half. It seemed like they had you in the first. What adjustments did you make there?
Well, like I said, my coaches do a great job of adjustments. I mean, you know, the difference is with us and a lot of other teams, all our coaches is on the field. So, you know, if we had a coach in the box, we might straighten that up during the game. But we came in halftime, you know, like I said, both my coordinators were right to the board. And a lot of times these kids, you know, you need to show them what to do on the board. And once we, you know, they drew it up on the board and they knew where they needed to be and who to block, and they calmed the emotions down because they were really hyped up coming into this game. Once they calmed down and straightened up everything they needed to straighten up, that really made us, was key in the second half for us running the ball.
Showed a lot of guts on that fake punt there, Coach. Was that your call?
Well, I can tell you this. One thing about us, you know, we trust our kids. They've been here for a while. They've been here a long time with the, you know, the winning teams, like I always talk about with the Tavons, and then they were on those teams. So when they get in the huddle and, you know, I can tell you, you know, they called it. They asked. You know, we haven't ran that since Powell. So we didn't know if they saw any or not. So then we haven't ran that fake punt that helped us out against Powell. So they asked if they run it. We ran it. We was just trying to get 10 yards out of it, but that really did. The turning point of the game was, I believe, them giving us the ball on a short field. We couldn't believe that they didn't punt the ball. When they gave us that ball on the 40-yard line, that really motivated us to score again, to go up. And that was, we felt, was the turning point of the game.
Talk about the fortitude of this team. Down 12-0, you guys played one of the worst halves I've seen you guys play in about a decade. And you guys were able to get off the mat. Talk about the fortitude of this program.
Well, one thing about the program is that my kids, they fight through adversity. They stay together. They're not going to come down on one another because of a mistake. Even when Epi fumbled the ball, they were all in there telling him to get his head up because, you know, just a week ago, he was the hero. So they know that we needed him, so it would not help them to come down on him. These guys stay together. They stay together all day long. So they knew we were down, but they wanted to win. So when we came in at halftime, like I said, they straightened some things out and they came out short. And that was the big deal.
Does this one have any special significance to you?
Everybody does it in a lot of folks, but to us, mm-hmm. Even though, because I know my kids. I know them, I love them, they know I love them like a father. They wanted this because a lot of folks felt that the run was over in a way. Mm-hmm. And a lot of these guys were on the team. They didn't play a lot, but they were on the team. So when we came up short last year, you know, all they heard was, you know, the Tavons and them, and this starts the cycle. I remember telling you, and I told Keith at the press conference, mm-hmm. I told you at the press conference, mm-hmm. This was like 06 to me, because in 06, this started the dynasty, mm-hmm. with the win. Mm-hmm. So with so many guys coming back, we just felt and we talked that this could start the next run. And these kids, they love Dunbar, and they just want to leave Dunbar with their name in that gym. That means a lot to them. They want their name in that gym, and they just happy that they'll be graduating, and they come back 20 years later, and they can walk up and look in that gym with so many great athletes and see their name on that wall. And that's what this is all about. Mm-hmm.